Okay, PC Games Girl here, and hello and welcome to Season 1, Part 1 of my Let's Play of The Lord of the Rings Online. And Lord of the Rings Online is also known as LOTRO, so if I say LOTRO, that just means The Lord of the Rings Online. That's just a shorter way to say it. And LOTRO is a free-to-play MMORPG, which means massively multiplayer online role-playing game. And this is actually one of the most popular ones out there, and personally I love it because I am a huge fan of Tolkien. And of course Tolkien wrote The Lord of the Rings, and it's his stuff, so I really love this game quite a lot. And right now I'm just going to be showing off each of the different races that you can play in this game, and I'm not going to touch on the classes very much at all, just because I'm going to be doing very in-depth videos on each of them later on. And I don't want to, you know, say the same thing twice type of deal. So that's why I'm not going to be going too in-depth on any of the classes at all today. But I will at a later date in other videos. Now, about the race of men, which is of course humans. The race that all of us are as far as I'm aware. It says, not as long-lived as elves, sturdy as dwarves, or resilient as hobbits, men are renowned for their courage and resourcefulness. And they start out with the gift of men, which is improved fate. Men have the greatest destiny of all the free peoples. The diminishing of mankind, decreased will. Men have weaker wills than the other races. Easily inspired, increased morale restoration. Men are more quickly emboldened than the other races. And strong men, improved strength. The feats of strength that men such as Boromir could accomplish are worthy of song. And here's the little movie on humans.
The age of man is fast approaching. The chosen of a higher power, men dominate the lands of Middle-earth, both west and east of the Misty Mountains. Their strength of will and prowess at arms will decide the fate of Middle-earth, whether for good or for ill.
Slightly ominous there. And sorry it was a little bit choppy, that's just how the video plays for whatever reason, I don't know why, but it is what it is, you know? Okay, getting the volume back where it belongs, and now for dwarves, which are only guys, but there are female dwarves, but you cannot play as a female dwarf. And anyways, about the dwarves, this is the class that my younger brother is going to be playing, because he and I are going to be doing this in a fellowship, but not from the very, very beginning. I'm going to start out playing solo, and then later we're going to play in a fellowship, which is just a group, and he's going to be a dwarven minstrel then, actually. But I'm going to be doing my Let's Play with an elven guardian. But in any case, on to the dwarves! Dwellers of stone and miners of metal, the dwarves are a doughty folk, resistant to the corruption of the enemy, but not to greed. And they have sturdiness, increased might and vitality, improved common damage mitigation. Dwarves are a sturdy race. They are also stocky, reduced agility. Dwarves are naturally less agile than the other races. Lost dwarf kingdoms, reduced fate. The dwarves' time in Middle-earth is fading. Unwearying in battle. Bonus to morale and power regeneration in combat. Penalty to morale and power regeneration out of combat. And all dwarves can use one-handed axes, and axes have a small chance of reducing the target's armor. And here's the little video about dwarves.
Calling the mountains and hills home. The dwarves are a sturdy folk. Dour-handed warriors, but also crafters of great skill. Many of their ancient halls lie in ruin, but their battle cry still resounds across Middle-earth. Baruch Kazad, Kazad Haimenu!
Baruch Kazad, Kazad Haimenu! Okay. Just in case you couldn't quite hear what he was saying there. Alrighty, and now on to hobbits, which are the halflings, and they are of course, you know, like Frodo and Sam and the main characters in the Lord of the Rings Online are actually hobbits. And you can play as a hobbit, which is awesome, because hobbits are freaking amazing, and I love hobbits. There's a dude hobbit, there's a girl hobbit. Hi, girly hobbit. She's amazing. I love hobbits. But anyways, hobbits are happiest when enjoying a simple life with 6 square meals a day. Hobbits are solid and dependable when called to action. And they have small size, reduced might. Hobbits lack the physical strength of other races. Oh, because they're tiny? They have hobbit toughness. Improved vitality. Hobbits are remarkably tough. Rapid recovery. Improved morale regeneration out of combat. Hobbits recover from trying times faster than the other races. They have hobbit courage. Improved fear resistance. The slow kindled courage of the hobbit race. And they resist corruption. Improved shadow mitigation. Hobbits have a great resistance to temptation. And now let's see the little hobbit movie.
Hailing from the rolling green hills of the Shire and the rustic towns of Breeland, hobbits are a simple folk, favoring food and good cheer above all else. But deep within even the meekest hobbit burns a spark of courage, waiting to be kindled.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Alrighty, and now to the race that I'm going to be playing, the elves. I really, really, really love elves, so most of the characters I've played are elves, which is why I'm playing one for this Let's Play, because I'm the most familiar with them and the quests that they start out doing, and just, I really like elves. I don't know, I mean, look at that face, he's so beautiful. But anyway, about the elves. Excuse me, goodness gracious. It says, long ago, the elves welcomed the younger races of Middle-earth and allied with them when the need was great, but centuries of war, betrayal, and hardship have made them fiercely protective of their seclusion. And the elves start off with sorrow of the firstborn. Reduced morale and morale regeneration out of combat. Elves feel things more deeply than the other races and are more subject to sorrow. Agility of the woods. Improved agility. The grace of the Eldar is remembered in legend. Fading of the firstborn. Reduced fate. The time of the elves in Middle-earth is nearly at its end. And suffer no illness. Improved resistance to disease and poison. Elves do not suffer illness. And this particular trait that elves have actually makes a fair bit of difference in gameplay from what I have noticed. They are legitimately a lot less likely to get diseased or poisoned, and it doesn't seem to last as long on them, which is great! Because certain enemies will give you disease or poison and whatnot, and that sucks. But anyway, here is the movie about the elves.
The kindred of the elves dwell among the woods and dells, lingering in Middle-earth out of love for the land. Though their glory is diminished, and the day draws near when they must cross the sea, those who remain continue the ancient struggle against the shadow of the enemy.
Alrighty, so that is the elves. That is the race I'm going to be playing, and I'm going to be playing as a guardian, as you saw before. And his name is Thanalos, and he is beautiful. Now, I will very, 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 very quickly go over the different classes, just to give you an idea of what their role is. The burglars can be either humans or hobbits, and they are an advanced difficulty, and they have a support role. Captains can only be humans, they are a moderate difficulty, and they also have a support role, and they can summon heralds to themselves, so they have a little dude following them around, helping them out, that they summon. Champions can be humans, dwarves, or elves, they cannot be hobbits. They are a basic difficulty class, and they are a melee damage class. The guardians can be any of the four races. They are a basic difficulty, and they are the defense role. They are the main tank in the game, which means they draw all of the enemy's threat to themselves so that the enemies attack them instead of their weaker allies. Hunters can also be any of the four races. They are a basic difficulty, and they are the main damage role. They are the archers in the game, and my first ever character was a hunter, and she's still my favorite because I just love me my archers. They are so freaking badass, these hunters. And lore masters can only be humans or elves, and they are an advanced difficulty support role class. They can summon different animals like eagles and ravens and lynxes and bears and different things like that, and they're really, really cool. They use magic, and I like my lore masters too. Minstrels. This is the class that my younger brother's going to be playing, although he'll be a dwarf. Minstrels can be any of the four races. They are a moderate difficulty class, and they are the main healers in the game. Basically, they scream at stuff and play music at it, and it either dies or it makes it heal their allies, which is freaking legit. Now, real quick, I'm going to switch to an elf, just because humans cannot be runekeepers. Dwarves and elves can be runekeepers. They are a moderate difficulty class and can be either damage or healer depending on which they are attuning themselves to. So if they do a bunch of damage spells because they're a mage as well, then they'll be doing all the damage, whereas if they're doing a bunch of healing spells, they will be the healer in the group. And wardens can be humans, hobbits, or elves. They cannot be dwarves. They are an advanced difficulty class, and they have a defense role, so they are a tanking class, but you can also do a fair bit of damage with them if you want to. And one thing is that runekeepers and wardens are not available at the very beginning of the game. You have to purchase them with turbine points. Turbine points can be earned through gameplay, or they can also be bought with actual money, depending on how you want to go about doing that. So that is how you go about getting a runekeeper or a warden, and personally I did some of both with how to earn them. I paid some money and I went like crazy earning turbine points in the actual game to unlock both of these two classes. So yeah, that is about the races and the classes that you can play. I'm actually exiting character creation because I've already made the character we're gonna be playing. Heck yeah! Alright, let's get into the game really quick. I am so excited. I will be right back as soon as we're actually in game. Okay, I'm back now, and we're in the game! Yay! And these little pop-ups here are little tutorial things which it comes up with every single time you make a new character. And personally, they rather annoy me because I've been playing this game for around 2 years now, so I know what I'm doing, dang it! But if you want to read that there it is. If you ever want to read these things and I just click out of them, just pause the video and go back there or whatever. But in any case, you can see there's Lord Elrond right there, and I'm going to be pressing the N key so floaty names are off because they really annoy me. Floaty names, look at Elrond over here, and you'll see his name is over his head when floaty names are on, but it's not when it's off. That's what they're about. I just press the N key to get rid of them. And I always roleplay when I'm playing, so I type /RP on, and now I'm officially roleplaying. And I'm going to use the WSAD keys to move around. Hello, my Lord Elrond, and yes, you can use the mouse to move around the camera. Like this, I am using the mouse buttons to move, and I am zooming in with my mouse wheel because I have a mouse. Hello, mouse. Hello. Hello, little Thanalos. Wait, you're not really little. What am I even saying? I don't know. My coffee's starting to kick in because I'm a total coffee addict, so don't mind me.
You cannot tarry here any longer.
Lord Elrond says, you cannot tarry here any longer, Thanalos. Skorgrim's forces are upon us, and I fear they make straight for this library. He seeks the relics of Edhelion, though I do not know what a dwarf could want with them. These relics were once coveted by a gaunt lord of old. I think the fool believes he can become immortal if he acquires them. Oh, jeez, that would be very foolish of him indeed. Here, young elf, arm yourself, there is little time. Alright, so I just right-click on the satchel, and now I can loot that. Yes, yes, I know. Alright, I press the I key to pull up my inventory, and in case you're wondering, this little horse thing I have because I have the Riders of Rohan expansion pack, and you automatically get that with each of your characters, that steed, if you have said expansion. And alright, time to equip some new stuff to myself. There we go. And now Thanalos has a new shield and a new weapon. And now I'm going to be talking to Lord Elrond again.
Good. You are better armed.
Your master Talagon wishes to see you before you venture out into the fray. But do hurry. This place is not safe for you. Yes, I know. Okay. I'm following you, Lord Elrond. I'm coming. Talagon, I have found your student. Quickly, say what you wish to say. Thanalos is not safe here for long. Hi, Talagon. He says, Thanalos, my dear student, I wish I could let you stay safe within these walls, but Elrond tells me that Skorgrim makes straight for this library. You must survive the battle outside, I am afraid. I worry for you. Duel with me one last time, my friend, and show me that you are ready. It will ease my heart. Okay, yes. I know about combat. I have him selected, which is why he's up here. And I will use these skills down here, which are my battle skills. Well, they're actually just the skills. skills I have equipped at the moment. Rah! Fight him! Fight him! Show him you can fight, Denlos. There we go. Good job. Now, these starting out skills for my little guardian here. I say little because he's such a low level. Our sting, which is a quick stinging blow. And Guardian's Ward, strengthens defenses briefly.
There is no time to waste.
There is no time to waste, Thanalos. Go outside with Talagin and see what can be done to stop Skorgrim from advancing. The Dourhands cannot be allowed to take the Gauntlord's relics. I have vowed to keep them safe. I will hide the relics, then I will join Talagin in protecting the library. Be safe, young Guardian. Thanks, Lord Elrond. Okay, yes, I know about doors. You can right-click on them to open them, and then when they have that portal thingy, you can go through! Yeah! Oh yeah, and I just made him jump by pressing the space bar. Because I like to have my characters jump randomly, because I'm strange like that! Alrighty, so that loading screen took forever, so I really doubt anyone minds that I skipped over most of that. Alrighty, so we're outside the library now, and oh my goodness, everything is on fire! Oh no! Yes, quests and quest rings. This I will read. Many characters and even objects will offer quests and information. Right-click anyone or anything with a ring icon to receive or advance a quest. Blue quest rings tell you that the NPC, which means non-player character, may have helpful reminders of what you need to be doing. Epic story quests will have a flaming ring to signify the importance of the quest for the main storyline. Okay. And as you can see, Mr. Talagin Silvertongue over here has a flaming ring over his head, so this quest is indeed part of the epic, because that's what you start out doing.
The shadow has risen.
Go, Thanalos. This is where the storm will converge. Edhelion is down below. He will let you through the gate to protect what is left of this refuge. Oh yes, by the way, I'm just saying this now. If I mispronounce anything in this Let's Play, I do apologize. I am trying very hard because I love elves and I want to say their language right, but I often fail. Come this way! I must defend the library against Skorgrim! Okay, I'm going. I'm going. I'll be back in one piece. I promise. Kill evil Dourhand. Come, Thanalos, quickly! I'm coming! I'm coming! Looks like he might be a guardian too, since he also has a spear. Wait, not spear. Oh my god, I've been playing Warden too much lately. I mean, a shield! He has a shield! Gosh dang it. Ah! Troll! There's a troll! Troll's scary! My little noob self cannot handle it! Let's go to the courtyard and bolster our defenses! I'm coming! Come this way, young one! Yes, I am coming! I don't want to die. I'm too young to die. I'm only 20. I don't want to die. Okay. Let me in. You should continue west, up the stairs. Eventually, you will make your way to the courtyard's west gate. Be wary of invaders along the way. They're everywhere. Hurry now! Hurrying! Oh no! It's a Dourhand and he's hurting an elf! I do not approve! Bad Dourhand dwarf! Bad, bad, bad! You will indeed fall to me. Oh yes, experience and leveling up. When you defeat enemies or complete quests, you gain experience. Earn enough, and your powers and stats will increase by leveling up. When your character levels, you will gain access to new skills and be able to equip bigger and better armor and weapons. And to tell how far along I am with leveling up, you can just look at this very bottom bar right here. See how it says level 1 right now? You need 92 XP for level 2. And the further along this yellow bar is on here, the closer I am to leveling up, and once it fills all the way over here, where right near where it says LOTRO store, then I will be leveling up very shortly afterwards. Alright, now, oh no, dead person. I think that was a dwarf though. Oh dear, because some dwarves are good and some are bad, these dwarves happen to be bad. Dourhands are evil dwarves. Come to my blade, dwarf! Die! Die, evil Dourhand! It can be! It can be indeed! Hey! Quit mourning over him! He's not worth it! He's one of you evil Dourhands! I don't care if he was your friend! He hurt my friends! Oh yeah. You're done, buddy! You are so done! Bad Dourhand! Bad! Okay, I need to kill one more! There's elves on that other side! I need to defend myself! Rawr! Die! Die, you evil Dourhand! Ah, it is Talagin's young charge. I will let him in. Thank you. Coming. I'm coming, Dorangor Whitethorn. We have lost much in our battle with the Dourhands. Tell me, though, what news do you bring? I bring news that you have a really pointy stick, and there's lots of dour hands trying to kill everybody! And a troll! It's
Maybe
a troll!
Morning.
I fear for Edhelion. How much more can we withstand? And I hear that Skorgrim has not even shown himself yet, which means the worst is yet to come. Oh, no. Oh, yeah, and really, really quick, I just want to note that each of the different races have a different introduction that they start out with. I hope your skills in healing are enough too, my dear. Oh no, coming! The final battle's at hand! The troll is coming! Oh no, it's gonna hurt us! Ah! Troll! Drama! Ah! Oh no! Help! Oh good! Lord Elrond is here! Elrond the badass has come to save us! Elrond, I love you! Elrond, save us! Thank you! Oh my god! He pretty much just yelled at it and poked it with his swords and BANG! Dead troll. Dorngor, come! Taligan alone defends the library! He sent me to save Thanalos! Thanalos appreciates this. And so does PC Games Girl, the one controlling Thanalos. Okay. Elrond! Oh no! What's going on? Oh no, Taligan! Ah! Oh no! There's Skorgrim! Oh no, Taligan! Oh no, what are you doing, Taligan? Ah! Taligan! Oh no! He's making an earthquake! Oh! Oh no! They're all dead! No! Oh no! This is a sad day. Taligan is dead. He was such a good elf dude. Oh no, he wished for me to be safe and now the relics are buried with him.
Edhelion is ruined.
Alas, Thanalos, you have lost your beloved master. You may blame me for his death. I could have saved him, but he bade me go to you instead. Taligan was brave to spare your young life. Edhelion is ruined now. Taligan was not the only elf to die today. Skorgrim will trouble us no more, and the relics are safely buried, but it was such a needless battle. Edhelion will fade. And now the intro is done, done, done. Yay!
The old refuge of Edhelion lies abandoned, a ruined testament to the greed of Skorgrim Dourhand. 600 years after its fall, dwarves inhabit the ancient halls in the mountains, and Elrond of Rivendell, sensing a threat, has sent his sons Elrohir and Eladan along with a company of elves to investigate.
Sounds exciting. Alrighty, well, I'm going to be showing all that stuff in the next part, that stuff being the prologue, because there was an intro, and then there's a prologue, and then you get to the actual game. But, yeah, once we get there, in a minute, once it loads, there we go. Alrighty, so I am going to be ending this part here. I hope that you enjoyed it. Please be sure to give this video a like and to subscribe if you have not done so already. In the next part, we are going to keep going through this introduction series, and I will see you all then, or in whichever video I upload next. Bye!